Hey loves, jumping right into this video, I just want to go ahead and let you know that I am doing an eyeshadow look, as well as I'm showing you some of the new Fenty products that I tried that just came out in this video. But right now I am prepping my hair for the orange hair paint wax that I will be using. I'm using the Camille Rose Naturals leave-in conditioner, and I'll leave everything I use in the description box below, and the Diva Curl Super Stretch. I noticed that, I don't know if these products just did not mix well, but as soon as I was done applying all these products to my hair, I noticed that I had a lot of flaking. So when I put this hair paint wax on, I noticed that once it dried, it was like snow. It already had flaked the last time, but this time it was worse. It didn't flake that bad last time, but this time it was very, very worse. So I'm just being honest with you that what you use could make and break your choices in using this product. Like, you might love it or you might hate it because of how your hair feels. And I didn't really like how my hair felt because of the product. So I don't know if it was the products or the mixture of the wax and just everything just was not coming together. Now, I noticed with this wax, if you have black hair, your hair will be a brownish kind of golden kind of brown color. And if you have blonde hair, my blonde ends took to it. Like, my blonde ends were orange, but the top part of my hair was brown where it was black. So I did notice that. And I did have to use a lot more on this than I did the aquamarine color, so keep that in mind. I also tried this on dry hair and I hated it. I hated how my hair felt. It was horrible. It was just like a horrible thing. So just keep that in mind when using it. To me, I use this on wet hair and then just use it a diffuser to dry your hair. That way it does not get all over the place, because this stuff gets messy if you air dry. So while my hair finished drying, because I diffused it but some parts were a little wet, I'm going to go ahead and do a quick makeup routine and just share my thoughts on the Fenty new products. Now, I got their concealer. I got it in the color 330. 330 is normally my color around the wintertime in the foundation, but I noticed that, as you can see next to Too Faced, that it's a little bit lighter, the concealer. So I know it's going to work under my eyes and on my face, but when I use the foundation, it's starting to look a bit more peachy. So, and with the color, I just look really, really pale. The concealer, I look really pale. So I'll be using my Too Faced foundation because it's a little bit more darker. And it worked a lot better with the concealer on my skin tone. So I'm just patting that in there. And then I'm going to use the new banana powder. And I'm just going to set my face. Now, I had no problem with this concealer. Again, it's just a little bright, so I used my darker foundation. But I noticed that with the skin tone next to it, that would have worked. It started to look a little bit more peachy. So this was the best color for me right now. I'll probably try it again around the summertime when I get a tan. So I'm using the Juvia's collection, and I'm starting with that brownish tan color. And I'm going to be putting it in my crease and just blending that all together. Now, the concealer is very creamy. I like it. Again, like I said, it just was a little bit bright. The banana powder, I wish it had probably a little bit more yellow to it, but it was fine for me. I had no problems with it. I had no flashbacks. My pictures looked really great. So I'm not really sure, because I know some people are saying they did not like the powder. So for me, I liked it. So that's just my honest opinion on it. Then I'm going to be taking that orange color, that reddish orange color, and as well putting it all over the crease. And I'm not cutting my crease or anything. I'm just putting everything together just like that and blending it all in. So then all over my lid, I'm going to use the Kilowatt Foil Mimosa Sunrise. And I'm going to use the orange, and I'm just going to use my fingers to put it all over my lid, and that's it. After that, I'm going to apply my eyeliner and my eyelashes, and I'm just using some Ardell lashes. I love those lashes. I really hate spending a lot of money on lashes, so that's just my preference. Then I'm going to clean up my shadow a bit with a clean brush, because it's just looking a little bit harsh. So I'm just going to clean it up a little bit more. Again, I am an amateur, so this is just what I do on my face. And once everything comes together, it looks a lot better. Just keep in mind that you got to trust the process, because sometimes it'll look a little crazy when you're doing something. But no, once you pull everything together, especially when you're new at this, it'll work. So I let the concealer dry a little bit, and I did notice that It had a bit of a shine to my forehead, so I don't know if it brought out the oils in my forehead. I'm normally not an oily person, but I did notice when I took a picture that it was a bit shiny even after I applied the powder. So that was probably my only thing that I side-eyed with the products. But other than that, it wasn't enough for me to take it back. I was like, maybe I just didn't put enough powder on my forehead because I'm normally not used to having to use a lot. So I said I'll try it again and see if I had to use more powder. But I just didn't notice that one part of my forehead was extremely shiny. So maybe it was me and whatnot, but that was really it. So this is just a finished dry look of the hair paint wax. The darker parts of my hair is brown and the blonder parts of my hair is orange. So now I'm just going to style my hair. I'm putting a little oil on my hair and the front part of my hair to try to move through it a little bit easier because it was so stiff. I don't know if it was the products or the wax just not playing nicely together, but it was extremely stiff and it had my hair feeling really funny. And I was jamming, y'all, so y'all gonna see me listen to this. You know, you can't listen to it because clearly YouTube is hating. So, but either way, I'm using the edge control from Camille Rose Naturals Lavender Collection. It's really good. It lays your edges. Like, I love it. And I'm just using my edge control brush. And then I'm going to twist my hair. And that's really it. I'm just going to show you how I twist my hair. I mean, I'm just rolling my hair. I'm not flat twisting because my hair is so stiff. I can't only do but that. And it was hard for me to work with, so... Again, I don't know. I'll probably try again with a different product and see if I feel something differently. But I know when I tried this on dry hair, it was extremely stiff. Like, I don't even know how some girls were able to do this on dry hair. I was like, oh my God, I hate this feeling. Like, is your hair okay? Like, I had to wash my hair out the same day. Like, I had let it sit, I let it dry, and I sat under the dryer, and my hair felt so crispy. So I knew this is something I would never use on dry hair. But also keep in mind that every time you touch your hair, you're going to feel a little bit of residue on it, especially if your hands are wet or has some kind of oil or something on it is going to get on your hands. This orange was a little bit more messier than the green. The green dried down pretty well. The orange took a little bit longer to dry fully, and even then I still had certain parts of the color on like certain things. But that's really it. You know, it's pros and cons to this stuff. If you're going to have a temporary hair dye, it's not going to be perfect. You know, you can't get something that's going to wash out and it's going to be just easy to use. I guess we just got to take the good in with the bad and how much you really want it. So I'm just picking out my hair a little bit more. I had to kind of move through it, but that's really it. So I'm using a metal pick because the metal pick is wider, it's longer. I'm not using a shorter pick. And because my hair is already a bit stiff, I don't want to use something shorter that could cause more breakage. The wider pick allows me to move through my hair without taking out a lot of the definition. It still allows me to have some definition to play with versus the smaller one would kind of comb my hair out. So I am using on my lips Rihanna's Freckle Fiesta, the orangey color lipstick, and this is the finished makeup look as well as the finished orange hairstyle. I hope you enjoyed my video, and I will be getting ready getting these Valentine's Day looks together soon. So, see you in my next video. Bye.